Welcome back to the Model Workshop. Now, this Saturday, we've had some issues with the car we are building, so we are going to do some unboxings throughout the weekend, just so you can get your model fill in. I know you guys, especially this time of year, with the snow coming and the leaves falling and the frosts happening and all that, are getting back into the workbench across the central northern United States. And we are going to start having some cool kits. I can't build them all that come into the show, but I do want to give you a look inside the boxes. This Saturday morning's first unboxing is AMT's International Paystar 5000 dump truck. It's in 1/25th scale. This bad boy is a deluxe kit. It has over 300 pieces, builds into a gorgeous model. From what I can understand of this kit, it would have been back in the Ertl days, and they produce some gorgeous machines. You can check out the other International I built, the other giant mining dump truck, on this channel and see how that comes out. We got gorgeous vintage style boxing on this thing. Look at this. If you're looking for this kit online, it will be AMT1381, or just search 1381, or International Paystar 5000 in 1/25th scale. It is a beautiful machine. They've actually got flotation tires, drive tires, an operating dump body, an operating tailgate, and it's got the big honking International V800 engine. Along here, we're going to have fuel tanks, we're going to have transmissions, and a gorgeous instruction manual that I will show you, and a large parts call out across the entire back of the box with our decal sheet. Look at all those tires in there. So let's start taking a look at the plastic that will be in the box when you snag yours. First up, we just mentioned the tires. Let's get them out here. There is a huge pile of tires in the box. Here's your steer tires, your flotation tires. And as you can see, the insides of the drive tires are missing. And that's because they're molded in two pieces. And all you have to do is take that ring and press it in. Some rubber cement will hold that in beautifully. Model cement usually doesn't work on these. Rubber cement, contact cement will hold those in without a fight. Super glue would probably work, but it will almost certainly cloud the outside of the tire as well. Gorgeous looking Goodyear tires, all name branded all the way around. The drive tires are the exact same way. They go in together so seamlessly that it's kind of hard. I couldn't tell exactly which one was, but these are Goodyears as well. Drive tires. And they look awesome. If you're not a big fan of that, just put that to the inside. You got duals in the back. And then on the front, you just put that to the inside if you think you're going to see a big seam. But rubber cement holds those together. I've done that before. There are no spares. You get exactly what you need in the model kit. Then we've got some transparent red marker lights, brake lights. You'll need those. Not all of them. You'll definitely have spares. We've got a clear set of parts. One piece windshield, I like that. We've got our windows and the doors if you want to use them. We've got the sight window and the passenger door. We've got our headlights and our rear cab window. Crystal clear on that, not going to have any issues. We've got some hydraulic lines for this vehicle. This is AMT's Round 2 models, new super wet noodle. We've seen this in a lot of videos now. Look how flexible that is. Doesn't really hold its shape at all, which means it's not that stiff vinyl that wants to fight you with everything. I love this. Whoever sourced this in your purchasing department, big thumbs up from Chris over at the workshop. We've got a nice decal sheet with a blue and a white hood decal that match each other, make your painting job so much easier. Even has the outside stripe on it. They've got the mark there, so you know where to line it up. Then we've got all kinds of company decals. Johnson Salvage, Rolling Ridge, Alaskan Excavation, Holland Gravel and Stone, Deli Trucking, Clouser Farms. I mean, we've got a lot on there. County Construction, County Commission, County Road Commission. We've got license plates, all kinds of instrument panel decals. These are one pieces, and then optional panel switches and knobs. These are individual decals, as you can see. The shadow goes across if you see one shape. We've got all the heil for the bed, mud flaps, some AMT cats hidden in there, unit numbers, warnings, AMT logos. It is a gorgeous decal sheet in this monster. We have a big chrome tree. Look at this bumper with grill guard. Oh, I like that. Fan, a lot of this stuff would not be chromed on the real thing, so you can either de-chrome it or just paint over it. Single smokestack makes perfect sense on a work truck. Got our grill with the International logo. Got our cab markers, individual windshield wipers, grab handles, one-piece mirrors. Oh, I love the truck mirrors that are one-piece. They need to find a way to produce this for all their trucks. Just mold just this part of the mold and stick it in a lot of their trucks. We've got our wheels here, front and rear. If you don't want them to be chrome, they don't have to be. I've showed you how to dull parts before. Got our little door handles are separate. Headlight buckets. Really extravagant on that chrome tree, but not overdoing it. The whole truck is in chrome. Now, instruction manual. We always cover these in the unboxings. Look at this thing. It is huge. Pictures of a completed model in two different paint schemes. Or actually, it's one that's just aimed different. It's actually really beautiful. And then these old Ertl manuals are really top-notch. I mean, they take you gradual step-by-step. Bring you through the whole assembly process of the frame with a completed painted chassis. And from what I remember of assembling that other International, they take a long time to build, but they do go together nicely. These could actually be a person's first truck kit after they've done some other model trucks and cars. An adult or a mature person with patience could make their way through this. It's not going to be in a day, but you'll make your way through it. So yeah, that is just an excellent manual on there. And then you can see some of the other trucks they produce on the back. All fine kits, and these old Ertl molds go together the easiest of all those kits. Now we've got things molded in multiple colors, so we're gonna start showing you that. We've got black parts tree here, where we've got engine, transmission, fuel tanks, frame rails. Look at the frame rails, and I like that the front suspension's molded in. Cab mounts, all the little holes in here, all the location marks. See the little location marks hiding on there? Turn that over. You can see our location marks on the frame, and then our chassis pieces right here for our suspension and driveline. It actually makes it much easier for you. We got our air tanks, belt and pulley system. We've even got tow hooks on this thing. I mean, just outstanding. Now we'll switch to another parts tree. On this one, we've got more of our engine and driveline, but we've got our wheel package. The wheels on these snap into place, so they do freewheel. Look at the suspension with the leafs. Our dashboard, raised detail. You put your decals over that, they look extremely authentic. Got shifters here, driver's seat, transmission, differential with cast texture. Got our frame, the other half of the frame. Part of our exhaust is molded in. So that's pretty cool. I've never actually seen that. Got parts of our cab floor. We can get our cab built over that. And yes, see, there's the old Ertl parts on the mold. The old name on there. Check out all the batteries even. So we'll set the black parts trees aside. That's all for the black. Over 300 parts total. So there's a lot of stuff to check out on these little beauties. Then we've got our dump bed, our dump box. Look at the frame underneath that. Check out the wood graining for the upper parts of the box. And I've shown you how to paint wood before, so check out any of those videos, especially the flatbed trailer I just did. We've got our mud flaps, the International and the Heil. International for the back of the front fenders, Heil for the dump body. Love that molded frame on that. Ertl really has some gorgeous truck kits. We got, that's one silver tree, since the bed is silver on this truck. We've got a second one for the bed sides. Look at the cool pattern in that plastic. It's very interesting. That would have been in the mold. Got our tailgate for the bed. Got bracing along the sides. You can see these braces here. What that will all go together to create is this bracing on the side of the dump body. This is where your RAM goes in the front, so this will be right behind the cab. And then you've got your RAM will go in here to lift it up and down. We got second silver parts tree. We've got a third silver parts tree. These are our hydraulics and various bracing and equipment inside the bed. And then look at these fine parts to hook up with all that hydraulic line. Got our tail lights, got parts of our cylinders. Look at all these little unions and fittings. I mean, this is really an extensive build, and I know you guys, a lot of you are master builders that watch this show, and you will have some beautiful creations. Then we go to a white parts tree for our cab. You can even see the pockets on the inside of the cab. They even thought to mold those in. Engine halves for that 800. Cylinder heads. Filters. Front of the engine. Got our interior doors of the cab. They look awesome. And then on this tree here, we've got our front fenders with that awesome diamond plate tread. Got our hood ribbed for your pleasure. All of our hood attachment points, grab handles. Underneath, just smooth. Got our fenders like that. Got our nose. Love the utilitarian look of an International. My dad drove an International quad axle for many years with the highway department, and he said it was tough and strong, but it was not the most comfortable rig to drive. Got our cab in one piece. Got a little bit of a bend. This is like the third thing I've had with some bend. See, now it's straight, so we're fine. Don't sweat the small stuff. We got our hinges on there. Gorgeous molding all the way around the back of the cab. Over the top, look at how everything is molded open. The air horns, the cab marker lights, even with their mounts in this one, all built in. And that's it. That's all the parts that are in this big, huge, 300 plus parts, gorgeous International Paystar 5000 dump truck kit. Now, at the end of this video, I will have a still slideshow of all the parts trees so you can get a closer look at them sitting still. And I want to welcome you to the show if you're new. And we will be bringing some more cool unboxings this weekend. We will be back with a regular build video on Wednesday. And I will see all of you at the next review.